Hello everybody, I'm live from Kumamoto. This is the first Only in Japan Go episode where I, on the go, making live videos from locations all around Japan. I'm in the middle of a month-long hitchhiking trip and I thought I'd stream live from beautiful Kumamoto, and you can see here, boom, there he is, Kumamon. Probably the most recognizable character in the entire country. And he's everywhere here. In fact, I think walking down the shopping arcade, I saw him maybe about 100 times. I didn't count actually, but he's everywhere. Now, I want to take you to the castle, but today is raining. You can see, it's not a very nice day. Panning up, there you go. So I can't take you around Kumamoto Castle, but what I can take you to is the shopping arcade, which is right there. Nice. This is actually a very nice shopping arcade. They're called SHOTENGAI in Japan. And this one is quite modern. I think it looks like it had been redone. I don't know any of the history or background to it, but I do know they have a Starbucks at the end, which I'll be going to, because I'm in dire need of a big cup of coffee. Kumamoto is a really, really nice town. I'm staying in a hotel, maybe, I think it's about a 3-minute walk from here. It's not a very special hotel, it's just a normal business hotel. But I'll be able to show that to you in another episode of Only in Japan. I wanted to take this time to explain to you what this show is all about before I answer some of your questions. So Only in Japan Go is different from the other channel because it's going to be almost entirely like this. Live streams from locations with me and my iPhone 7 Plus and DJI Osmo Mobile, where I can take you and walk so smoothly around the city of Kumamoto today. And that's pretty much all there is to it. That's all there is to the Only in Japan Go. It's me, you, some camera equipment that doesn't always work well, and a bunch of people staring at me because I'm holding a selfie stick in the middle of the city. What are you gonna do? This part of the SHOTENGAI is really exciting because it has more bright lights and more people.
こんにちは。今
ライブ streaming YouTube だよ。
Oh my god.
303人。 名前は何ですか?
My name is Naoki.
Naoki? あ、 英語話せる?
今話した、ちょっと。
あ、そうや。 Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Okay, go ahead. どうぞ。 All right. Bye-bye. 君の誕生日 boy. Hey.
Yay.
Hey. I don't know. Just walk around the city with a selfie stick and you're gonna get people that jump in front of you. You gotta love Kumamoto. I gotta tell you, this place has been really amazing. And this is sort of why I'm having fun doing this hitchhiking trip, because I get to meet people all the time. Like that. Different than Tokyo. Because I live in Tokyo, I'm not a tourist, and now I'm a tourist. I'm out here in the elements like everybody else, and it's so much fun. So that's the concept of Only in Japan Go. Unscripted, anything can happen. Like those two university students or high school kids jumping in and saying hello or something. I don't know. I think they just wanted to be part of whatever I was doing. At the end of each episode, I'm gonna try to take a break and then answer some of your questions as well about Japan. So I think it's a good opportunity through this format, the live streaming, to do that. I'm so thankful that this channel is not really big yet, Only Japan Go. So I'm so happy for everybody watching right now. It's sort of it really is a big deal for me to get. Yeah, I think I had 1,500 subscribers before I had any content on there. So I'm want to just say thank you. Arigatou gozaimasu. Arigatou gozaimashita. To everybody who subscribed right away. That makes me really happy. Oh, look. It's a Mr. Donuts. I love Mr. Donuts. Come back, Osmo. Take a look. I could use a donut. I was gonna get a coffee, but now I'm sort of into the donut. Look at that. Oh, it's been true. Hey!
Yay!
That was fun. A bunch of girls just jumping in this screen. I know. What's in the water here? People are really, really happy. People are happy, Kumamoto. Excuse me. Now, a little bit about Kumamoto. It was last year that they had the earthquake that devastated the city, and I got a chance. Let me turn this around. I got a chance to look at the castle yesterday, and it's still under construction. You could see where the roof had fallen off, and there's a part in the back of the castle where it just completely all toppled over. And I asked the construction guy how long it's going to take to reconstruct everything, and he said maybe like 10 or 15 years. They really don't even know. So it's sort of sad. Coming in, when I hitchhiked from Kagoshima into Kumamoto, in the area where the earthquake epicenter was, there's still a lot of debris, and you can see blue sheets on people's roofs because they still haven't been able to repair the roof of their houses. The water would come through without those blue sheets, and it's been, I don't know, almost, what, 8 months since the earthquake? I can't remember exactly when it happened, but it was last year, and it disrupted so much production in the city. So I think it's good. I think people are happy to see tourists coming back to Kumamoto. And I'm happy to be part of that. All right. So I'm going to get to the end of the street and then take some of your questions. But... Ah, Matsumoto Kyoshi, I need something over there. Need to get a toothbrush. They gave me a toothbrush in the hotel, but it's so plasticky. I don't know. The bristles stink on it. Have you ever heard of Matsumoto Kyoshi there?
Yeah.
It's pretty cool inside. They seem to have everything in there. Wait a second. Down boy. Okay. Ah, there's the toothpaste and toothbrushes. Okay, that's what I was looking for. These are cheap. Alright, I'll be back after the coffee. Yeah. Alright. So I'm going to be in Kumamoto for the next couple of days. Or maybe until tomorrow, I'm not really sure yet. It depends if I'm trying to schedule an onsen visit to film there. And if they let me, then I'll be here for another day. If not, I might go tomorrow to Fukuoka and continue with the hitchhiking. But these live streams are going to be on this channel. Maybe a couple more on the Only in Japan main channel, and then back here on the Only in Japan Go. Wow, this rain stinks. Gosh, you can see behind me. It's miserable today. Yesterday was such a beautiful day, and today is just... absolutely chilly and rainy, and it's one of those spring days that just stinks. Up there is the city mascot Kumamon. Somebody hung him from the rafters, and that's not cool. Poor bear. Alright, another thing I should explain about the Only in Japan Go channel, this is all streamed using Docomo's 4G network. So if you're getting not HD size, which is, I guess you might be seeing 480p or pixelated video, that's because this whole thing is streaming live on YouTube through Japan's 4G signal, only in Docomo. I have a SoftBank iPhone 6 Plus too, but this is the iPhone 7 Plus with the front selfie camera. So, is the quality awesome? I'm getting some comments here from Frank de Los Angeles. Thank you for that. Good, I'm glad to hear that. Docomo has, they say, the best network in Japan, so that's one reason why I got this phone and then used their SIM card. I got it last week because I thought that this would be the best to stream video with. Is it 720? No kidding. Awesome. That's what I'm aiming for, because HD would be really expensive. I'd lose all my bandwidth in one video. Oh man, I just ate ramen. I didn't live stream it, but I also like this curry place. Coco curry. Oh, it's so good. It's a chain shop from Nagoya. It's based in Nagoya, but I don't know. I think I'll stick with Kumamoto local food instead of the chain shops. Oh, they're selling DVDs. Oh, there's some pachinko. Okay, so I'm pretty much at the end of the street. I'll take some of your questions now. I'm gonna stop here for a bit. I have this on a selfie stick, and the reason why is because I want you to be able to see the background. Come on, DJI. You made me pay an arm and a leg for this stick. The least you could do is work. Okay, there we go. Sorry for the shaking. There you go, okay. So let's take a look at some of your messages here. Questions. Katsudon, yes, I'd love to eat a katsudon maybe later. I will do some more 360 videos. The goal is to do it with the cherry blossoms, but the cherry blossoms haven't bloomed here in Kumamoto yet. It's late this year because they said they've had a very cold spring. Let's see here. What am I doing? I'm live streaming from Kumamoto. Well, I'm hitchhiking from Kagoshima, the lower tip of Kyushu Island, all the way up to Hokkaido in a month. And while doing that, I'm going to be live streaming and making a video. I'm trying to fund this through Kickstarter and Patreon, but Kickstarter turned down my plan because they said that I've already started the project and I have to convince them otherwise. So I'll give you the link later if people are interested in that. What should I visit when I go to Japan? Kumamoto, first of all, because I happen to be here and I've been having an amazing time. The people just jumping in front of the video, they're really happy people here. I love Hiroshima. Kagoshima was awesome, and that's where I just was. They have the volcano that just erupted three days ago, Sakurajima, and the Tsunomushi Onsen, the volcanic sand bath, which I also jumped into 2 days ago, which is really awesome. Onomichi, I don't know if I'm going to be planning it to visit on this trip. Eat some desserts. That is really good. I could go for dessert. I just had ramen and a bowl of rice for lunch. What do you love most about Japan and what do you miss about America? I miss the people in America. I like talking with strangers in line and just... It's sort of like people were jumping into the video here in America. You can just talk with people very easily. At least that was my experience. Here, people are very closed. And in America, people are more open. I kind of miss that. I miss pizza. But the things I couldn't live without here in Japan is right over there. I can show you one. And the other thing is the convenience of Japan is unquestionably amazing. The convenience stores, the trains, just look at this corner here. This is awesome. The bicycle parking? What? Just everything is just so organized. You can see here on the map where the bicycle parking spots are for motorbikes and scooters and bikes. And then they've set it up where it's all automated and clean. And you can use an IC card, you see? You can scan your IC card or put in cash. If you have a problem, you push the buzzer. That is the most amazing thing. And you get a ticket when you enter. You pay when you leave. Oh, that's the exit. Recycling bins for the vending machines on the corner here. Look at that. I love the vending machines here. That's something I miss when I go back. The vending machines in the US stink. I don't know why. I guess it's people don't like vending machines as much. These are all hot. You can see in the red on the top, and these are all cold, the blue. Sumetai, cold. Yeah.
Here's some more.
This is a Coca-Cola vending machine. Do you see any Coca-Cola? Do you? They're up there in the corner. And there's a very small one. I can tell you right now, Coca-Cola is not popular in Japan very much. It's not big at all. People don't want to drink much of it, so you get bottles that size. Here's my hand to show you. That's my hand and that's this bottle. So, Japan is very clean. Except for those up there. You see? The crows. They're kind of scary, man. Ah! They don't take kindly to strangers. I've been attacked by a crow before. I got a Super Plus Fanta. That looks pretty interesting. Extra vitamins. Nice. How do you Japanese people react to my skin color? I don't know. Some people, that's a really deep question. I'm walking back to the Starbucks now before I cut the feed. That's a really great question. I think in Japan, people like, gaiken is your outer appearance, is quite important in Japan. And to the Japanese people, historically, white skin was, this is all generalizations, not all people are like this, okay? White skin was considered a thing of beauty. So people who worked out in the fields and the farm all the time, they always had dark skin. So farmers who didn't make a lot of money, they were poor people. And people with fair skin didn't work so much outside and they were richer. So I still sort of see that today. Like people have skin whitening and stuff like this, whereas I prefer the Okinawa girl look, you know, where she got a little bit of sun and they're not afraid of getting a suntan. They look more like me, maybe. But a little bit. It's a little bit different. It's easier for people if they have blue eyes, for example. I don't know why. It's just it's a Japan thing. I don't think about it too much. The thing is, if you speak to people, after you get past the first impression of the way you look, this is an important lesson for everybody, and this doesn't just happen to be for, isn't just for Japan. Once you get past the way somebody looks and you start talking to them, in the first 30 seconds, all of those images of what you thought of that person completely change. And this is not just for Japanese people, this is like everybody around the world. So your skin color, for our generation, it doesn't really matter that much. I think once you start talking to somebody, your opinions change. Once you make friends with somebody, like I did in the car, the guy came around, he picked me up, he didn't know who I was. He didn't want to take me all the way to the city. After about an hour, he asked me where I wanted to be dropped off, and I said, anywhere's fine, service area, I'm going downtown to the castle. And then he decided to take me down to the castle. It was because he spent some time with me and he got to know me and we became friends. So that's a really good question. It's really deep, but my opinion on it is that. I don't think about it anymore. I'm happy who I am. But you can tell initially, skin is sort of a deal here. Do you like it if people call you John, although you don't know their names? I don't mind. If people call you John, and although you don't know their name, I don't mind. I've met a lot of viewers of the show that came to Japan as a tourist, and they would yell my name, and it was ecstatic. I was like, what? How do you know me? Ah, that's right, I make this show. And, you know, as I said, we get to know each other, you shake hands, take a selfie, and go about your day. And that's really, for me, that's fine if you call me by my name. Do you like anime? Yeah, I like anime. Maybe not the ones that you like. I watch the old anime. I learned Japanese from anime, basically. Chibi Maruko-chan and Sazai-san, which is on TV here in Japan on Sundays from 6 to 7, Fuji TV. I do use LINE, but I don't want 1,000 people sending me stuff on LINE. Sorry about that. I will, however, I was thinking about this. Those who sign up on Patreon, and I'm not doing this, I am doing this to try to fund this trip. Those who sign up on Patreon, I'm going to give people a way to contact me. So when I live stream, I'm going to have this iPhone 6, and I'm going to talk to people live in the future, because I don't want to talk like this and read your questions. This stinks to me. I want to hear your voice, all right? So those who support on Patreon, I'm going to give the phone number of this phone, and then you can contact me, and then I will talk with you live for a couple of minutes, and I think that's gonna be a lot more fun. So I'll be walking around like this, and I'll have your voice live on this phone, and we'll be able to live stream, and then all of you watching will be able to hear the interaction. That's really cool, because these, you can't see them, but on the left side of my screen, these things, they're too fast, and I can't get into the questions so much. I thought that was a pretty cool idea, so. Let's try that. Hey, Carlos. See, Carlos wrote something really nice, and it went by too fast. I gotta go back. Big fan here. I like to see the Disney parks. Yeah, I was just there a couple weeks ago. Can I ask you, Carlos, something? You have a Disney pass. Is that in the U.S.? Can you use that here in Japan to get in if you have an annual pass in another country? Does that translate? Not translate, but does that work across borders? I'm really curious about that. The voice chat might be a little bit more confusing. The potential problems with that is that I'll get a phone call from 100 people at the same time. So I'm trying to find a work around that, but it'd be nice though to talk with people, because right now I'm just talking, I'm rambling, and it's better to have somebody else with me talking. Yeah. Anything about special about Kumamoto? Yeah. There's Kumamon, who's above me. Everything has Kumamon in it. There's food. Kumamoto is famous for basashi. Anybody love horses? Yeah, I love horses, but in Kumamoto, it's famous for eating raw horse. It's called basashi. It's raw smoked horse meat. It's okay. They're also famous for renkon, which is the lotus root, and they put spicy karashi mustard in it. That's famous in this area, as well as kumamon and onsen. And shochu. They're famous for shochu. So, yeah, I was pretty upset to eat the horse the first time, but that was almost 20 years ago, so. Now I'm a little bit okay. I don't think of it as a horse. I think of it as just meat. That's the only way to get through eating raw anything, really. I think, you know, people ask me about that. A lot of vegetarians are watching. For me, I have to separate myself from the animal and the meat. You walk into the grocery store and you see meat aisles, right? That's like the body of an animal. And you have to just say it's meat. It's there. And if you think about the chicken or the cow, which we probably should more, it's hard to eat it, period. So I can see both sides. Sorry, the signal dropped out, sorry. I speak Japanese, English, and a little bit of Espanol. So I'm gonna go get this coffee. I just wanted to spend the day with you guys, and there's my destination for right now. I don't know why I'm going for Starbucks coffee, because I can't find another cafe. I just wanted to share a couple of minutes with you and show you this Kumamoto Sun Road shopping street called the Shotengai in Japanese. And introduce the show. Thanks. Thanks everybody for tuning in. I'm going to cut off now. It's been interesting. I like this format. In the future, I'm going to pick one thing to cover instead of rambling all over the place. This is a special episode, but I'm going to pick one thing to cover, and then I'm going to just focus on that and then take your questions at the end. Like, everyone's turning around to watch me, see if they look back. Yeah, she looked back again. I'm going to focus on one thing, and this is going to make the live format a lot better. So, I'm signing off from Kumamoto with me and Kumamon. Thanks for everybody for watching. If you have any questions, write them down in the comment. See you next time. See you on the road.
Thank you.